found that saved a wretch like me.
Mercy reigns, unending love.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Sacred Heart St. Joseph Parish. Please stand and join in our opening hymn, number 610, Thanks Be to God, number 610.
And good afternoon. Amen. We gather in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. And my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. And we pray, I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I've failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Father.
And let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you've rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Our first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. As the Lord spoke to me, the Spirit entered into me and set me on my feet. And I heard the one who was speaking to me say, Son of man, I am sending you to the Israelites, rebels who have rebelled against me. They and their ancestors have revolted against me to this very day. Hard of face and obstinate of heart are they to whom I am sending you. But you shall say to them, Thus says the Lord. And whether they heed or resist, for they are a rebellious house, they shall know that a prophet has been among them. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, that I, Paul, might not become too elated because of the abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh has given to me an angel of Satan to beat me, to keep me from being too elated. Three times I begged the Lord about this, that it might leave me, but he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. I will rather boast most gladly of my weaknesses, in order that the power of Christ may dwell with me. Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and constraints for the sake of Christ. For when I am weak, then I am strong. The word of the Lord.
And the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus departed from there and came to his native place, accompanied by his disciples. When the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astonished. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What kind of wisdom has been given him? What mighty deeds are wrought by his hands? Is he not the carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James, Joseph, and Judas, and Simon? Are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor except in his native place, and among his own kin and in his own house." So he was not able to perform any mighty deed there, apart from curing a few sick people by laying his hands on them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. And the gospel, the good news of the Lord. Well, tonight in the gospel, Jesus comes home to his hometown, to his native place. And if there's anybody that knows about coming home to your native place, it's me. I know all about that feeling of coming home to your native place after being 6 years stationed in Kansas City, and then 9 years I was in that wonderful metropolis of Opie and Hartford, way out there in the big city. Yes, I was out there for 9 years. And finally, I came back to Topeka. I'll never forget when the Archbishop called me when I was in Opie. He called and he said, "Father Tim, I would like you to move." And I thought, oh no, because I loved it out in Opie and Hartford. I really did. I loved it out there. And I said, "Oh, okay, Archbishop, where do you want to move me to?" He said, "Topeka." Well, I kind of got excited when he said Topeka. And then I said, "Well, what parish will I go to?" He said, "Sacred Heart St. Joseph's." And right away, I mean, the excitement was there. I was so happy when he said that. And I said, "Well, you know, Archbishop, that's my home parish, because normally, as a golden rule, we don't come back to our home parishes. It doesn't happen that often. So I was kind of surprised when he said, Sacred Heart, St. Joseph, but here I am. Do you know, I figured it the other day. I haven't thought about it, but I did think about it when I heard about all the other guys moving this year. Do you know, I have been your pastor for 17 years. Can you believe that? I know it. I hope I get another 17, but yes, I've been your pastor for 17 years. And I can tell you, in those 17 years of being home, it's been great to be with the people who know you the best. They've known me since I was a kid, a lot of you do. You know me from when I was little. And to be home with all of you and to be home with family, it means so much. And I think the Archbishop has been very, very good to me. So I can't say anything bad about him because he's been very, very good to me. But when I think of those 17 years, I've had nothing but wonderful experiences since I've been home. And working with all of you and praying with all of you, I found a deep faith amongst all of you. You have a deep faith. Maybe I don't tell you that enough, but you do. It's a strong faith. So when I think of that, I think how my experience has been so different than the experience that the Lord had in the gospel tonight when he went to his hometown. When he went to his hometown, he found a lack of faith. They didn't believe in him. Whatever he told them, they said, how can this guy that we've known since he was a kid, how can he have such wisdom and authority? Or when he said he was the Son of God, they all said, how can he say he's the Son of God? We know his parents. We know Mary and Joseph. Isn't he the carpenter's son? They knew him, but yet they failed to believe in him and what he taught and what he commanded. Jesus taught with authority, and when he taught with authority, he taught by his own authority. He didn't teach from the prophets and the law. He said, do these things because I say to do them. Well, the people kind of took offense at him, and they weren't very happy with him. In fact, Jesus wasn't able to perform very many works there. He couldn't perform too many miracles because of the people's lack of faith. It even says in the gospel that he was amazed by their lack of faith. So today, let's pray for us. Let's pray that we may put our faith and trust in the Lord and believe in him and be able to celebrate that faith in our lives and not be like those of his native place who didn't want to believe in him. You know, there's been a couple hiccups along the way when I say how my people really know me. And that is, I remember when I first came back to Topeka, I ran into a girl that was in my class in high school. And when she saw me all dressed in my black, you know, with my white collar on, she just looked at me and she goes, I can't believe you're a priest. She remembered me from my high school days. And of course, I said right back to her, well, I can't believe you're a high school principal either. But that's hard to believe, too, that all the trouble we used to get into in high school. Well, I remember on my ordination day, I think I've told you this before, but I'll tell it again. I'm getting older, so I got an excuse. I can repeat myself. And that is Sister Mary Carita, my grade school principal, on my ordination day, she came through the reception line. Everybody was shaking my hands. And she grabbed my hand and she held it firm and she said, "Now I know that God draws straight with crooked lines." Coming back home, you gotta love it. Everybody knows you for who you were and who you are. But yes, I've had a couple hiccups along the way. So today, let's pray that God gives us the grace to believe in him and to trust in him. Let's stand now for our creed. I believe. Born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Eternal Father, confident that you hear and answer our every prayer, we now present to you our humble petitions.
Let us pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may lead us to a deeper faith in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray that we may place our trust and faith in the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the peace in the world, especially in the Ukraine and in Israel and Gaza. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of our sick and their caretakers. May they know of the healing hand of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of those who have died, especially for the souls of William Frank Everett and John Everett, from whom this Mass is being offered. May they come to share in the eternal joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and loving Father, hear the prayers we offer you today. In your love and mercy, answer them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please join in our offertory hymn number 745, America the Beautiful, number 745.
Across the world.
And pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. And may this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph and James, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Of all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. And let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace.
Thank you. Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin.
And behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in our communion hymn. It's number 478, Fly Like a Bird, number 478.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth. The Mass has ended.
Please join in our closing hymn, God Bless America.